This is KPFA or KPFB in Berkeley or KFCF in Fresno. This program is the Weekend News, and I'm Anthony Fest. Yesterday, activists in Washington, D.C. and around the country rallied against war and occupation in Iraq and Afghanistan, the 7th anniversary of the March 20, 2003, outset of the Iraq War. But Africa scholars, journalists, and activists noted that there was little or no mention of the Congo War, which they also blame on the Pentagon's manipulation of tensions and militarization in the Central African region. The United Nations describes the Congo War as the most lethal conflict since World War II, and the International Rescue Commission, a conservative relief organization, estimates its death toll at nearly 5.5 million. In January 2008, others now estimate it to be more than 6 million, perhaps as high as 10 million. The violence has recently escalated again, and this week, Doctors Without Borders protested that government soldiers had barged into a hospital in eastern Congo, harassed medical workers, and removed 4 wounded patients, whom they described as rebels. Anne Garrison has more.
Law professor Peter Erlander, lead defense counsel for the International Criminal Tribunal in Rwanda, explains that the ongoing Congo War began in Uganda and Rwanda.
We had 2 wars to contend with. One was a war of invasion of Uganda by Yoweri Museveni and Paul Kagame, the current president of Rwanda, that resulted in 500,000 people being killed before Museveni seized power in 1986. 4 years later, 25% of Museveni's army under Kagame's control and command invaded Rwanda, and that was in October of 1990. And they carried out a guerrilla war and then eventually a military frontal assault and assassinated the previous president as part of their war plan. And both of those operations, we can show, were financed by Britain and by the United States Pentagon. So there's actually 500,000 deaths in Uganda that was resulting from U.S. support for Museveni. If we agree that it's 800,000 that died in Rwanda, we certainly know that both Uganda and Rwanda invaded the eastern Congo in 1996 and again in 1998. They continue to occupy the eastern Congo today, and at least 6 million people have been killed there. So we can say with some certainty that the entities that the U.S. Pentagon and State Department are supporting in Central Africa, Museveni and Kagame, are actually responsible for somewhere in the neighborhood of 8 million deaths in the last 15 years. It's not only unimaginable, it's so off the radar that good people in the United States don't understand it, particularly since there's been a great deal of propaganda.
Erlander says that the U.S. State Department, the Pentagon, the U.K., the U.N., and the Museveni and Kagame governments have all conspired to hide the reality of the Congo War and the wider war in Central Africa. For KPFA News, I'm Ann Garrison.